I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong. In this video, I'm gonna give you a direct comparison between the Dexcom G6, so this one, and the Libre 2. I've been wearing the Dexcom G6 system since it came to market, and I definitely have loved it, but it also has some downsides. So when I got my hands on the Libre 2 sensor, I thought, why not try and wear both sensors at the same time so that I get a direct comparison and get a better feel for which system I prefer. I'll be going over my experience wearing both products at the same time in this video. This is, of course, my personal experience, and I can't guarantee that you'll have the same experience with the products. So let's get started. Let's talk first impressions here. So again, I have both sensors on. When I look at the size, I mean, the Libre is clearly smaller, even though a lot of this is tape, it's still smaller. It's also flatter, which is hard for me to show. I don't even know how to show that. Maybe like that. There you can see the Libre is flatter than the Dexcom G6. So from a size perspective, I mean, the Libre is definitely smaller. Pain level is the same. There was no pain. I mean, you saw I didn't flinch when I inserted those. The insertion process, maybe it's just because I've done the Dexcom so many times. I just think it's a little easier that it's all in one applicator. You just have to peel off the paper and apply it. I mean, it wasn't hard to put together the Libre 2, but it was just a few more steps. And then something else that I'm often concerned about is trash. So this is not including the boxes. This is a trash from the Libre 2. See, I'm throwing around. And this is from the Dexcom. It's about the same. I don't think any of this can be recycled either. This cannot be recycled, especially I live in California. This is considered a sharps container in California. You cannot throw that in the trash. You should not throw needles in the trash, period. So there's that. But overall, I'm looking forward to trying this. I say the last thing now that I remember is, you know, first impression again, this is only an hour warm up. This is 2 hours warm up. So again, there are pros and cons to both systems. Looking forward to see how it goes. So I wore both systems. Both of them are off the arm now. You see there's a little bit of glue left, but that's about it. So let's talk about my experience. I rated both systems based on 10 different criteria, and this is the score sheet. As you can see, well, I'm giving the results up front here. For me, Dexcom was a clear winner. But if you want to know how I got to these results, stay tuned. I'm going to be walking you through each criteria. First off, how well did the sensors stick to my skin? So both sensors stayed on for the full duration of the sensor lifetime. So that is 10 days for the Dexcom G6, and that is 14 days, 2 weeks for the Libre 2. I'm not super surprised about this, as I have fairly dry skin and not a lot of body hair, so sensors actually tend to stick on really, really well. I can even have a little bit of a hard time getting them off. So both systems get 1 point in this category. Next category is whether or not you need an app or a receiver to see your blood sugar readings. When I started this experiment, the FDA had not yet approved the Libre 2 app, so I had to use a receiver. Funny enough, halfway through my experiment, the FDA actually approved the Libre 2 app for iOS only. So that means that if you have an iOS phone, so an iPhone here in the US, you can now get the alarms and the readings directly on your phone rather than have to use a receiver. If you have an Android phone, that has not yet been FDA approved, so you will still have to use a receiver. Since the Libre app was not yet approved, while I was doing the experiment, I only have experience with using the receiver. And to be honest, I'm not a fan of the receiver. It's another device to haul around, and I found that the battery time is fairly short. It was 24 to 36 hours, meaning I had to recharge it every night. With Dexcom, I have the option of using either the phone or the receiver or both at the same time. And I'm a huge fan of the Dexcom app. I even like the receiver. So with the Dexcom app, it's really easy to see all your readings and you don't have to swipe like you have to with the Libre 2. Since this review is based on my experience wearing the sensor this time and I only had access to the receiver and I didn't like the receiver that much, Dexcom wins this round. Now let's talk accuracy. If this review was only based on the first 24 hours of me wearing both systems at the same time, the Libre 2 system would win hands down. This Dexcom sensor was absolutely bonkers. It was completely off the rails and I had to aggressively calibrate it to get it back in line. This is not usual behavior for the Dexcom sensors, I would say. I've been wearing the Dexcom for a long time and usually it's not that off. But, you know, both sensors can be inaccurate the first 12 to 24 hours, so it is to be expected. I haven't seen any good side-by-side comparison of the accuracy for the two systems, but on the Dexcom website, it does say that it has demonstrated better published accuracy than the Libre system, especially at critical times. But all that being said, let's look at my data. What you see here is a comparison between my Dexcom data and my Libre 2 data. And you see up top, we have my average blood sugar. So for Dexcom, it had an average 123 milligrams per deciliter. For Libre 2, it's at 110 milligrams per deciliter. And time in range below, so that means how much of the time I spent between 70 and 180 milligrams per deciliter. You see it's 88 versus 87. So very similar. Given the inaccuracy of the first 24 hours of, well, mainly the Dexcom for this one, but for both systems, I pulled a week of data starting 2 days after I started the sensors. And as I said, as you can see, the sensors performed very similar during this time period. And that's what we should be able to expect from an FDA-approved medical device. So it's kind of nice to see. They weren't the same though, and I didn't expect them to be. But I consider them to be similar in the sense that they're only 13 milligrams per deciliter apart. And that to me is insignificant. I also did finger sticks throughout this little experiment. And what I found was that on average, Libre was ranging a little bit lower than my finger sticks, whereas Dexcom was a little bit higher, but it was only marginally. On average, my Libre readings were 4 milligrams per deciliter lower than my finger sticks, whereas my Dexcom readings on average were 8 milligrams per deciliter higher than my finger sticks. So we're still down in the very small differences and I don't think they're significant. Given there were hardly any difference in the average glucose readings between the two systems, and the difference that I did see was very small, I'd give both systems a point for this. Let's talk system updates. The Dexcom G6 will update every 5 minutes, whereas the Libre 2 system will update the glucose readings every minute. Remember that the readings that you see on your CGM is generally 10 minutes behind your blood sugar readings. And that's because the CGM will measure your blood sugar in the fluid underneath your skin, not directly from your blood. So since Dexcom only updates every 5 minutes, that technically means that the reading that you see on your screen could be 15 minutes behind. So Libre wins this round, hands down in my opinion. Now let's talk about system alarms. So alarms is a feature that you can turn on so that the system will alert you if your blood sugars are traveling out of range, high or low, or if the system is not working as it should. The Libre alarms are really basic. You can set a high alarm or you can set a low alarm or lost signal. You define what high means for you. So is it 160 milligrams per deciliter, is it 250, whatever. But those three alarms are the only ones you can set and they will sound automatically. You don't have to swipe for the system to alert you. If you use the Dexcom G6 app, the alarm features are much more refined. You can't turn off all the alarms as you can with the Libre system. You will always have to have the 55 milligrams per deciliter, the urgent low, turned on. In the Dexcom app, you can set high and low alerts. You can set fall rate or rise rate, meaning if your blood sugars are rising or falling really quickly, the system will alert you. You can also set up signal loss or no reading. Aside from that, you can also do customized alerts for different times of day. For example, if you want a different alert schedule during your work hours or maybe overnight. I think Dexcom is superior here, so that's another point for Dexcom. I think both systems are equally painless and comfortable to wear. I didn't feel any of them while wearing them. I could sleep on my side, not a problem. The Libre is visually slightly smaller than the Dexcom G6. It's not enough to bother me, might be for you, but for me, it doesn't matter. So for this, both systems would get a point. Next thing I looked at was integration with other systems. As it is right now, Libre 2 is a bit of a standalone system. It doesn't integrate with any insulin pumps or insulin pens. It will integrate with the Omnipod Horizon once that comes to market, but that's in the future. Dexcom, however, is integrated with the Tandem insulin pump as well as the InPen. So the InPen is a smart insulin pen. It's the one that I use. I'll link to a video about that pen up here. You can also see your Dexcom readings on your Fitbit. That's where I see it, as well as on Apple Watches. I can even ask Siri to read my Dexcom readings out loud, which is super helpful if I'm driving or I can't get to my phone. For me, Dexcom is a clear winner here, and probably one of the main reasons why it'd be a little painful for me to switch from the Dexcom to the Libre. In the past, I've had quite a bit of sensor errors, sensor failures with the Dexcom system. However, I didn't have any with this particular sensor. I only had one Libre 2 sensor, so of course my experience is based on, well, only one sensor, but this particular sensor was giving me a bit of a headache in the sense that it was giving me several sensor errors. It was giving me actually a lot of receiver errors as well. They all resolved themselves, so the system came back online by itself. I didn't have to call Apple to get a new receiver or a new sensor. One situation though was where my blood sugars were dropping quickly. So given I'm still wearing the Dexcom G6 system, I could see it there. I had two arrows downwards and then the Libre gave me a sensor error. That's of course not a situation where you really wanna see that. Solely based on these two sensors, I would say Dexcom would win this round. However, given it's only two sensors, and I've had issues with Dexcom in the past, and this might just be one faulty Libre sensor, I'm just gonna call it even. Both systems offer reporting. If you use the Libre 2 system, you go to LibreView.com and you can see all your reporting there. If you use a receiver, it won't be uploaded automatically. You have to upload it manually using a cable. The Dexcom reporting software is called Clarity, and you can either download the Clarity app or you can use your computer. And if you use a receiver, you do have to manually upload it. If you use the app, it'll automatically upload your data. Both systems will allow you to download reports where you can see your average blood sugars, your time and range, your daily patterns, and your daily blood sugars. I find the Dexcom reporting a little easier to read and a little bit more informative. For example, in Clarity, you can go and specify time ranges, whereas in LibreView, you can only choose full weeks. But I have also been using the Clarity reporting tool for quite some time, so it might just be that that's what I'm used to. Aside from going in and looking at your reporting, both systems also allow you to share your readings directly with your medical provider. This one is a little harder to call. Both systems are good, but given that I can't customize the reports to the same degree in the LibreView as I can in Clarity, this one goes to Dexcom. Finally, we can't ignore the price tags. These are expensive gadgets. I called my insurance and they actually cover both devices at a daily rate. So for me, there's no price difference between the two systems. They will both set me back about $70 a month. But your insurance, if you use commercial insurance, will have a huge impact on how much you're gonna end up paying. So I'd suggest that you call them and simply ask them about the price of the two different systems. I can't tell you exactly how much you will be paying for either of the systems, but I went to Costco.com, went to their pharmacy, and I tried to look them up. So what I found was that one Libre sensor, and this is for 2 weeks wear, cost about $60. So that's a daily cost of $4.30. On that side as well, I found the Dexcom G6 sensors, and there you get three sensors, each 10 days wear, so 1 month of sensors for $300. So assuming 30 days in a month, that would be $10 a day. You do need a transmitter for the G6 system as well. So I looked at the transmitter, that was $130. So that's $1.14 a day. So that brings it up total cost of $11.40. So that's significantly more expensive, than the Libre sensor. Again, the Libre sensor was $4.30 a day, whereas the Dexcom G6 sensor was $11.40. So quite a difference there. Even though for me, the price would be the same for the two systems, I know that would not be the case for most people. So Libre wins this round, hands down. I showed you the final score up front, but if you're still with me, let's just revisit it. As you can see, for me, Dexcom G6 is the superior system. This is, however, based on some level of personal preference. And it's also based on me only wearing one Libre 2 sensor simply because that's all I had. Thank you so much for watching this side-by-side comparison of the FreeStyle Libre 2 system and the Dexcom G6 system. I hope it gave you a little bit more insight into the systems, and hopefully you can make a more informed choice if you're debating between them. If you'd like to see more from me, please click the subscribe button and you'll be informed whenever I post new content. I also appreciate any interaction, so please give this video a like or a comment below. Thank you so much for watching.